Hi there, Serdar Yagulalp here from InfoWorld at IDG. Today I'll be talking about Poetry, an all-in-one system for managing projects in Python. You might remember in my last video I talk about pipenv, a system for managing dependencies in Python projects. Poetry does that, but also a whole lot more. What I mean by all-in-one is this. Some languages, like Go and Rust, have command line utilities for managing every aspect of a project, setting it up, satisfying requirements, keeping those requirements up to date, compiling and running, managing the execution environment, and so on. Python does not have a single official utility for all this, but third parties have made up the difference, and one of those third-party projects is Poetry. Poetry is useful not just because it manages Python projects, but because it manages projects for all your Python installations. To that end, you don't install it in Python as such, but as a separate application. So to that end, I'm going to install Poetry using the PowerShell commandlet described in its documentation. And once Poetry is installed, it can be run from the command line by way of the command Poetry. Now that we have Poetry installed and running, let's create a new Python project with it. All you have to do is go into a directory where you want your project directory to appear and type Poetry new with the name of the project, in this case just my project. As you can see, Poetry creates the directory and populates it with some basic project scaffolding. If we look at the directory, we'll see a few files there. PyProject.toml is the definition file for the project. This should not be edited directly, though. Poetry will handle that. readme.rst is a boilerplate readme file that you can fill in as you need for your project. Tests is a subdirectory to hold unit tests, so you can start writing them side by side with your existing code, something I really needed to get into the habit of doing. And finally, a subdirectory with the project's name, which holds the project's actual code. By default, a new Poetry project doesn't have a virtual environment associated with it. To do that, we use Poetry's env-use command, and we pass along the path to the exact Python executable we want to use. I have a few different Python executables in my system, so I want to use Python 3.8 to create the environment for this specific project. Once the environment's created, we'll get back the path to the environment, which we can then use to configure an IDE or some other work environment. Now, I've mentioned before how Poetry manages dependencies for a project, much like pipenv. Poetry lets you specify dependencies for the project itself and for its development separately. So for this project, if I want to add one or more dependencies, I just use the Poetry add command. In this case, I'm going to be adding the dependency piglet. Poetry will then install the needed dependencies in the project's virtual environment and lock them to the version specified. Now, if I want to add a dependency for development, I can use the same command, but I just use the D flag to indicate that this is a development dependency and not an actual project dependency. So I will do that with black and mypy. Now you'll notice that when a project's dependencies are created, a lock file is also created for them in the project directory. This lists all the projects and their specific versions so that project's dependencies are reproducible. This way, if you pass a project along to another person with the lock file included, they can use Poetry to install the exact same requirements with the exact same dependencies. If you like this video, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more Python tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.